Here we have a generic system of linear equations. x1 up to xn are the variables. The aijs and bi's are constants. They are usually taken from some field. But they could be taken from some other structure where addition and multiplication are defined. What we want to do is find values from f that could be assigned to x1 up to xn so that all these equations are simultaneously satisfied. Normally, f is the set of real numbers or complex numbers, but we might also look at some other structures as well. There are very good reasons for studying systems of linear equations. Many applications rely on being able to solve systems of linear equations very quickly, for example, weather forecasts, factoring integers, optimizing investment portfolio, etc. So we're going to spend quite a bit of time understanding systems of linear equations. In particular, we want to find ways to solve them and look at possible any mathematical structures that can come out of them. But we're going to take baby steps. For that, we'll look at a couple of special cases, and we'll work over fields. So there are two special cases that we're going to look at. The first special case is when there's only one variable. And we'll look at an example. In this example, we'll work over the rational numbers. That means x could be any fraction. Now the question is, can we find a rational number for x that will satisfy all three equations? And the answer is actually no. To see this, let's do the following. So I'm going to label these three equations 1, 2, and 3. Now, if you look at 1, you can rewrite that as x equal to 4 because if you multiply both sides by 1 half, the left side becomes x and the right hand side becomes 4. And if you look at the third equation, multiplying both sides by 1 third will give us x equal to 2 thirds. Clearly, x cannot be 4 and 2 thirds at the same time, so there's no solution. And in general, if we have a system that has only one variable, it's not that difficult to solve. What we do is, we do what we have done up here. We try to turn every single equation to the following form. So in general, transform each equation to the form x equal to beta, where beta is a constant. And then all we have to do is, we just look at whether all the betas are equal. If they are not, then there's no solution. If they are, then beta is the solution. Now, to transform an equation like the second one, we need to multiply by a negative number. And in this case, multiplying both sides by minus 1 will give us x equal to 4. So if we just look at 1 and 2, we won't be able to say that there's no solution. Looking at 3 together with 1 and 2, we'll see that there's no solution. So that's the first special case, when there's only one variable, and that's rather easy. The second special case is when we have more than one variable, but there's only one equation in the system. Again, we'll look at an example. So the equation we're looking at is x1 plus 2x2 minus x3 equal to 5. And we want to find all possible rational numbers that we can assign to x1, x2, and x3 that will make this true. I'm going to rewrite things a little bit. So I'm going to leave x1 on the left-hand side and add minus 2x2 to both sides and add x3 to both sides. Then the left-hand side will become just x1 and the right-hand side will be 5 minus 2x2 plus x3. Now notice that no matter what rational number we assign to x2 and x3, we can get x1 using this equation here. For example, if I set x2 equal to 0 and x3 equal to 1, then I will have to set x1 equal to 6. So if we allow x2 and x3 to be any rational number, then x1 will be 5 minus 2 times whatever value x2 is plus whatever value x3 is. So we can specify the solution as a triple. And x2 say some rational number s and x3 some rational number t, then x1 will have to be 5 minus 2s plus t. And this will give us all the solutions to this single equation. So this special case again is not that difficult. So we'll move on to the more general case when there's more than one variable and more than one equation. And that will be the content of the next video.